back with some new Brooklyn Savvy panelists. We have Mary Zias. She's from TD Bank. Thank you so much for coming on our show. TD means a lot to us. They sponsor
us. Thank you for inviting me.
And, of course, Christine Dunson, Clara Villarosa, and we're joined by Lisa Bing. So, anyway, to pick up on our discussion, what's the importance of business plan? I mean, I hear a lot of, I'll write you a business plan for $1,500, whatever that number is, but it seems like it's this critical document that needs to take place if you want to go into small business.
You do need some kind of plan, and it depends upon what you need the business plan for.
Exactly.
If you're looking for money, most places will require something. Mm-hmm. If they're going to give you money, they want to know who you are, what it is you're doing, how well are you going to do it, and how are you going to pay the money back with interest.
Right. Right. I think there's often a misunderstanding around business plan when they're getting started. I've got to write a business plan. Well, do you know exactly what it is you want to do? And sometimes it's more about the marketing plan if you're not going to the bank to get money.
The marketing plan. Yes.
When you go into a bank, let's just say, and you want to ask for money, no matter what the amount of money is, first, you're going to sit down with somebody, and you're going to discuss with them. We want to know, what do you need the money for? Where is it going? How long have you been in business? You have to make sure you sit down with someone and first ask the questions. It's like going into a store. All right, I want a dress. Well, what is the dress for? What's the occasion?
Okay, right.
Is there a specific color?
Yes,
you know, are you going to need shoes to match it?
Right.
So you have to have that conversation, and you have to learn what the customer wants.
Mm-hmm.
What are their needs? What are they using it for? And like you said, how are you going to repay it? You're so right, because if somebody walks in, let's just say, and they're a brand new business, the sole proprietorships that we were talking about before, where's the money coming from?
Right.
You're starting new. That's where SBA might come in, and there's different resources for you to get money.
What is that? Could you talk a little bit about SBA? Small Business Administration, of course, right?
They don't loan money. Right. Most people go in and says, I want...
They give you a grant?
Exactly.
Believe me, they ask.
Where can I go for a grant? Is it profit or non-profit?
If it's non-profit, you can get a grant.
Okay.
But if it's a profit-making business, there are no grants. Unless, if you're a veteran.
Okay.
Right.
But SBA,
I got to go to Iraq now.
SBA does not loan you the money.
They guarantee.
They only guarantee the money that the bank loans you.
Oh.
So and that's when you need
to go to the bank.
Mm-hmm.
So the SBA says, you may go to this bank.
Mm-hmm.
They will loan you the money, and I will guarantee 90% of that loan
in
case you default.
So that's basically, right?
But that's when a business plan will come in.
Right.
And if you come to me, let's just say you walked in and said, I'm starting a business, and so forth and so on, do you have a business plan? No, I could at least tell you, you know what, there's certain places you could go to get a business plan.
Mm-hmm.
You get the business plan, and then from there, we'll guide you on where to go.
I couldn't go with a marketing plan.
I left Prudential with a severance package. So I had some money, and it didn't take a lot of money for me to get started.
So you self-funded your business.
There you go.
And I self-funded my first business because I'm an ex-banker.
Yeah.
If I had come to me and asked me for money, I would not have loaned me.
No.
Exactly. The first question is, would you loan yourself that
money? No, I would not have loaned myself.
There you go.
So you self-funded.
I self-funded it.
And what about in kind and trades and all those kinds of things? Did you have to do that kind of stuff?
Books, so I would go to radio stations and offer free books as giveaways, or I could offer tips, or do a business review, or do a book review on a radio station.
Mm-hmm. But those are low-cost marketing tips,
exactly.
And that's part of the marketing plan, whether we call it that or not.
Call it that. That's what
it is. But a lot of people are not clear about what they really want to do,
right?
And that is their problem. So they think they have this fuzzy idea.
Yeah.
And I just met with a woman who was starting a PR firm. And what do you want to do? It took 30 minutes to get to what. That's a clear clue.
Thing, though? Doesn't that mean you might not be
ready?
I go
to my book?
Yeah.
There you go.
The reason that I wrote this book, in some ways, is I ask you the right questions in order for you to give me the answer to help you to decide whether this is going to be a sustainable business, and you should really be going into doing this.
That's right.
And so we call it the first 10 steps, because I list them out to give you some kind of a roadmap, because you can't go on rambling to the bank.
Exactly.
And you need to concretize it. You mm-hmm. need to take it out of your head mm-hmm. and put it to paper.
That's right.
So
mm-hmm.
it doesn't have to be elaborate,
no.
but put something to paper.
So it doesn't have to be elaborate.
No.
So what does it need to have?
Basically, it has mm-hmm. to talk about you. Mm-hmm. You're the one that's starting it. What are your credentials for doing this?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What's your capacity?
Your background.
Right. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Number two. Mm-hmm. What is it that you're doing? What did you say?
Yes.
Be pretty clear
right.
about it
yes.
and explain mm-hmm. it in such a way that somebody else can understand it.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Mm-hmm. How are you going to organize this business? What is it that you're going to be doing? I'm going to be selling handbags.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I will be storing these handbags. I will be selling them to who?
Yeah.
Who are your customers?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Who are they?
Right.
And how will you get to them?
What kind of marketing plan do you have for that part?
Yeah.
How
exactly.
do you get to them?
That was the business idea for mm-hmm. us was easy. It was the marketing
yes.
plan that was the challenge because we knew exactly what it was that we wanted.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But to how to get that
yeah. how to get
was
to them.
The challenge.
So what was
right.
where were you, and where are you going to mm-hmm. put that business?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to put it in your home? Are mm-hmm. you going to rent space? And how will that work? Location, location, mm-hmm. location,
now,
and money.
You're a Brooklynite in that you have two daughters that have lived here for a really long time.
The left lane.
Yes, yeah. You're a Brooklynite. So you made some observations as you walked down Atlantic Avenue. Let's hear a little bit about that. I'd like
yeah.
to hear what you thought about our wonderful, bustling Atlantic Avenue.
Well, I thought about it, and I also thought about Christine's business.
Mm-hmm.
And so as I walked down Atlantic Avenue, I was looking at what kind of traffic was there.
Mm-hmm.
I was looking at pedestrian walk traffic, also
mm-hmm.
cars going in which direction mm-hmm. and where might they be going.
Mm-hmm.
I looked
mm-hmm.
at the businesses around you.
Right.
What were
mm-hmm.
they doing? Were they mm-hmm. similar to you, different for you, or were they businesses that enhance you?
Mm-hmm.
And so that I automatically went to that place
mm-hmm.
as I was walking down and thinking about mm-hmm. your business.
And that's a mind of an entrepreneur who's
mm-hmm.
who's looking at opportunities all
yes.
the time when you talk.
And I
about
thought,
that.
I wonder how they work together. Her business is it must be a destination
mm-hmm.
because I don't see a lot of traffic.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore,
not during the day, right? And you're an evening business. You're
yeah, so there's no traffic time. In the evening either.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Her business is definitely a destination.
Huh.
So marketing is
spot.
Critical.
Now, Christine, when did you start your business?
We opened 2 years ago.
Two years ago.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we just introduced food and extended our hours.
Mm-hmm. That's
so
what you look at. How to work the hours. How to get the people in. What do these people want when they get here?
Mm-hmm.
Why would
now
they
you
come
decided,
here exactly?
You
yeah.
said
how you
first it was drinks.
Yes.
Then you said, oops, I need to add food.
yeah.
Right. Get out
oh,
of
yeah.
Here.
Right. No, it makes a difference.
Right.
Yes.
What
people's expectation of their experiences
right. Right.
is definitely changed by food.
And keep right. in touch with those customers to understand what are you doing well
yeah.
and what
mm-hmm.
you need to improve.
Follow-up is mm-hmm. just
yes.
you're
the
listening
biggest,
to your
the
customer.
Biggest.
That's
yes.
exactly what you're doing so you could be more successful and you realized, wow, you know, I had this in plan when I first started.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to serve these great drinks and so forth,
mm-hmm.
the great atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
But wait a minute, every time somebody walks in, they're hungry.
Right.
So
right.
there you go.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Can you